Nursing school is very stressful. Nursing school can be very overwhelming. I mean, it can take a toll on your emotions, your mind. Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Opoemi Goddess, and on this channel I talk about love, relationships, nursing lifestyle, and basically everything fun. If you're new to this channel, thank you so much for stopping by. For my returning subscribers, thank you so much guys for sticking to this channel. I really love you and I celebrate you guys. So today guys, I'll be talking about something related to nursing, and it's about nursing school and how we can actually survive nursing school. So if you're a nursing student and you're wondering how you can actually survive nursing school, like, you need survival tips, I'm here for you today. I'll give you the survival tips that you need, you know, to get through nursing school and all the things you need to do just to ensure that you don't get overwhelmed with nursing school. So guys, let's just get right into the video. So guys, nursing school is very stressful. Don't be deceived. I know people might tell you, oh, you can actually go through nursing school easily. That's a big fat lie. Nursing school is very stressful. Nursing school can be very overwhelming. I mean, it can take a toll on your emotions, your mind, your, you know, everything about you can actually be affected, either positively or negatively, you know, by the rigors and the stress of nursing school. So you have to be prepared for that. Anyway, survival tip that every nursing student needs to survive nursing school is the fact that you have to believe in yourself. And I will just start off with that. That's the first thing that you need. Like, you can't survive nursing school if you don't believe in yourself. See, the program itself, I mean, nursing itself will make you feel like you're not up to the task. I mean, the program, everything during your, you know, during your nursing school will make you feel like you can't do it. There are times that you feel like, am I really sure I can scale through this program? Am I sure that I can make it through my final year? Like, a lot of times you feel like you can't do it, and that is why from the onset you need to believe in yourself. This is the first survival tip. You need to be courageous, you need to be fearless. Gosh, you can't afford to be timid in nursing school, because the program itself will crush you emotionally, psychologically. You will be so stressed. Nursing school requires a lot of hard work. It requires a lot of tenacity. It requires a lot of discipline. So first of all, believe in yourself that you can do it. Believe that you have what it takes to go through nursing school and graduate. And just ensure that you have the right mindset. You have to believe in yourself. If you don't believe in yourself, trust me, you can't make it through nursing school. But if you believe in yourself, if you know that you have what it takes, you're courageous, you're fearless, you know, you're like so confident. You need that confidence to you know, to get through nursing school. So that's the first thing I feel that is necessary to get through nursing school. Please and please believe in yourself. You have what it takes, you know, to get through nursing school and to graduate successfully. You have what it takes to be a great nurse. So have that at the back of your mind. The second tip that you need to know, or you need to learn, is to ensure that you take your studies seriously. I'm saying this because until you get into the program, you will think it's so easy and it's something you can actually do easily. But getting into the program, you discover that it is actually very, very stressful and it can be overwhelming. So please take your studies seriously. Ensure you don't miss classes. If you have to miss any class, make sure it's for a genuine reason. Maybe you're sick, maybe you have to, you know, travel for any, you know, any serious function. Make sure you're missing classes for genuine reasons. You don't want to be the kind of student that would always abscond from classes. I mean, other students in other departments can afford to miss classes. Nursing students cannot afford to miss classes. And this is basically because one topic that will be taught today will be related to the topic that will be taught next week or next day. I mean, all our courses, all the topics and courses that we take in school are all intertwined. They're all related to each other. So if you miss one particular topic, it might be difficult for you to catch up on the next topic that will be taught, because they all are related. They all are like intertwined. Like, you can't leave one topic and embrace the other topic. All the topics need to be embraced. All the courses need, you know, to be embraced. And that's one thing about nursing school, because everything is related. Whatever you learn in your first year will still be needed in your third year. Whatever you've learned in your second year will still be needed in your fourth year. Like, everything is related. Everything is related. So if you're missing classes, ensure it's not something that you do habitually, and just make sure that you're doing it for a genuine reason. And then whenever you miss classes, please catch up on those classes. So your classmates that were able to attend those classes, you know, go ahead and meet them, tell them to give you a recap of, you know, the class, tell them to teach you what was taught in the class. Don't just be nonchalant about the fact that you missed the class and then you just ignore it and wave it aside. No, because you'll be so surprised to know that that particular topic that you missed, I mean, you only missed one class in a semester, you'll find out that the particular topic that was taught in that particular class that you missed might be all that will be required of you to pass a particular test or to pass a particular exam. So please just try your best, ensure that you don't miss classes, and even when you do, just try to catch up on all those classes that you've missed. You really need to be disciplined in nursing school. The third survival tip that you need to know is the fact that you should always do your homework, or your assignment as we call it. So please, whenever you're given assignments, take it seriously, because most times those assignments are eventually tagged as a continuous assessment. So I know for my own nursing school, I schooled back in Nigeria, and continuous assessment is like, it makes up about 30% of the overall 100% that is required. So the main examination is like 70%, while continuous assessments will make up about 30%. And there are times that some particular tutors or some particular lecturers won't even bother to give you continuous assessment anymore, because you've done some assignments, they've given you some assignments or homework. So what they just do is your homework or your assignment will be converted into your continuous assessment, because they know that a lot of students don't take assignments or homeworks, they don't take them seriously. So they will just act cool, give you assignments, they won't even take it seriously. They won't even ask you to submit those assignments, and then you just discover that you may eventually even end up taking a test. I mean, the tutor might still come back to your class, the lecturer might come back to your class to give you a test, which you would think would serve as a continuous assessment, and later on they might totally just ignore your test. You might have done well in your test and they would not even like reckon with the test. They might just eventually go with the scores that you've had in the assignments that were given to you earlier in the semester. So as a nursing student, you really really need to take your homework seriously, take all assignments seriously, even presentations, because I know back then we used to do seminar presentations, you know, PowerPoint presentations, group discussions, group presentations. Take all those things seriously. They matter a lot of times lecturers don't even bother, you know, taking all those tests you've had into account. They only just take your group presentations, your seminar presentations, and every other assignments that you've been given. They take it more seriously than the test itself. So please take your assignment seriously, take all presentations, all homeworks, and every other thing, just take them seriously. The fourth point, or the first tip that will help you to get through nursing school, is to discover your own studying skill. And this is because I see a lot of people trying to copy their friends. I mean, you might have a friend that loves to read in the night. I mean, your roommate can actually be the type that reads all through the night, and you are not that type of person. But until you discover your own way of studying, you won't know what will be applicable to your own situation, and then you end up copying your friends, copying your classmates who read maybe all through the night, or some who read all through the day. Discover your own way of studying. It is always different. Don't follow the crowd, don't follow what other people do. I remember back in nursing school, some people will read all through the night, and some other people who have not discovered their own, you know, method of studying will also follow those people to read at night, and eventually they will sleep all through the night and we will not be able to even read one page, I tell you. So please ensure that you've discovered your own pattern of studying. We all have our own pattern of studying, and then even if you have friends that study for longer hours, that doesn't necessarily mean that you have to study for longer hours. Like I said, discover your own pattern of studying. We all have our own pattern. Discover your own pattern. You may not have to study for several hours, you may just have to study for a few hours, and then you may be the type that would really really need to study for several hours. So that's it, guys. Just ensure that you understand your own method, your own pattern of studying. So the other tip that I would like to mention is the fact that you should develop acronyms for everything. Like during nursing school, whenever you're taught a particular topic, or if you're having challenges understanding a particular topic or a particular course, what I would advise you to do is to actually derive or develop acronyms. You should develop mnemonics, and then you can even develop songs for all the topics that you find so difficult to understand. I remember that we used to do this back in nursing school. Like if there's a particular thing you're finding so hard to, you know, learn easily, or if there's a particular topic that is just giving you a very, very hard time, give it an acronym, give it a mnemonic. You can even create a song out of it. That way it will stick to your memory and you won't forget it easily. I used to do that a lot back in nursing school. I had loads and loads of acronyms for everything. I had loads for every topic, for every course. I had loads and loads of acronyms. I had mnemonics. I had songs. That would really help you to master a lot of things. Like, because imagine you singing a song over and over again. It will stick to your memory and you won't forget. And then during exams, if those kind of topics or those kind of questions are being asked, you can just sing along and then put down the answers. It is that
so the last survival skill that I would like to mention is the fact that you should always reward yourself for every little step. So after every exam back in nursing school, I would always reward myself. I mean, once I'm done with all my exams for a particular semester, I would just take myself out. I will buy myself something. It could be a dress, it could be a lipstick, something not so expensive but something I can afford. I would always give myself a treat. I can go and get a bowl of ice cream. I remember I used to do that. You know, just reward yourself for every little step you take, please. That would always, you know, motivate you to do more. It would be like a driving force for you because you'll be motivated to do more. So after every exam in nursing school, please endeavor to reward yourself and to just give yourself a treat. I hope all these tips will actually help you survive nursing school. So if you're aspiring to be a nurse or you're already in nursing school and you're just wondering how you can get through nursing school, so these tips will actually help you to, you know, get through nursing school without feeling overwhelmed or feeling frustrated. Hope you guys have enjoyed this video. If you have any other survival tip that you think would help every nursing student out there, please put them in the comment section and let's all learn together. Thank you so much guys for watching. If you're yet to subscribe to my channel, please subscribe to my channel. Please like this video. Please endeavor to share to your loved ones and click on the notification bell so you always be notified whenever I put up videos on my channel. Thank you so much guys. See you in the next video. Bye.